I said, if you are a youth in the house, use the energy of youth and shout aloud, hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus said, what I'm speaking, they are spirit and life. And it's this word that carries the spirit of your destiny. Let the word come. Let the word come. By the power of your spirit, send this word to me. And it's a word that will change my life. As a destiny that I was born with. There is a word that has the key to that destiny. Let the word come to me. I will say that the word of Joseph came. Then his deliverance came. God separated him and made him a minister to senators to teach wisdom to the palace. Some of this word will come today.
Amen.
Father, let my word come. 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 In the name of Jesus. Lord, we are grateful for opportunity. Opportunity to come into your presence. Opportunity to fellowship with one another in your presence. Opportunity to be used as a vessel in your presence. Father, there is just a reason, a purpose. There is a word that anchored that purpose, unveil it to us. Let the power in your presence, hidden in that word, make today a day of glorious destiny for us.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Father, for that. Jesus, mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Can I hear a better amen?
Amen.
So I want to speak briefly on the master key to victorious relationship. Master key to the victorious relationship. Master key to victorious relationship. I want to read two scriptures before I go on. Proverbs 23, verse number 7. Proverbs 23, verse 7. Are we all here? He said, for as he thinketh in his heart, so is he. It has been said to thee, but his heart is not within. As he thinketh in his heart, so is he. The book of Colossians, chapter number 1. Colossians, chapter 1, verse number 27. Colossians 1, 27. To whom God would make known what is the riches of the glory of his mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. Christ in you, the hope of glory. Don't forget we're speaking of Master Key to victorious relationship. Now, life on earth is made successful in relationships. There is nothing tangible on earth that God can achieve with a man without relationship. There must be a relationship between God and man, vertical relationship, and then there must be relationship between man and man, horizontal relationship. The Bible says, Jesus increased in wisdom and stature and was in favor with God and with man. Now, that is a perfect relationship. Now, he has a relationship with God, increasing in wisdom, increasing in stature. He has a relationship with man. You know, so, and he closely watches this relationship. Exactly by this time last week, I was speaking on what I call the reading from my life triangles. Now, some of the greatest relationships are located inside the triangle. So when you want to succeed, you must find out where you are and the triangle that sustains the place in order to be victorious. So when I talk about master key, you know what is a master key? It's a key that opens all doors. If it is like a master key for a car, it simply means that when you bring it into any car, it must open. If it's a master key of your house, whenever you bring it to any door in that house, it must do what? Now, when it comes to relationship, there is a master key that when you have it, you will be victorious. Now, you see, when we talk about relationship, we look at the end to the beginning. Frustration comes when people don't consider the end or don't consider the beginning. You jump into something in the middle and you want to succeed by love. Hear me, on earth, people don't succeed by love. Anybody who depends on love to achieve or to succeed in anything must end up as a slave. Hallelujah. So the scripture says, as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. Now, a man of God came to me with a challenge. The wife made up his mind that he cannot continue with him as a pastor. Now, what is the challenge? The challenge is that he used to be a businessman, very successful. And then along the line, God called him to ministry. The wife was happy with him and was enjoying, you know, the good business of a successful businessman. When he came into ministry, the demand of ministry changed his mentality. And the wife couldn't fit into the new mentality. And then she began to revolt. So the relationship, what do you think about the relationship? Should a man go back to becoming a businessman so that the wife can fit him? Should a woman change into a pastor's wife overnight? So have we all agreed that there's a problem now? Now don't live your life without seeing yourself in the future. Don't jump into a relationship because of environment. Try and see like God. You are made in the image and likeness of God. Now, when God wants to look at a thing, he will look at it, eternity past, eternity future, and then eternity present. He will take his decision. Now, why we get frustrated is because we don't look into the future. We don't even have time to check the past. Why God brought you here is because it is going to change in your life in Jesus' name. Now, the master key to this victorious relationship is mentality. Somebody say mentality.
Mentality.
Can I hear mentality?
Mentality.
Now, what to relate with is the mentality of the person. I say what to relate with is what? Is mentality of the person. Don't do anything with anybody until you know how the person thinks. If you want to have relationship in business, find out how the person is thinking. If it has to do with marriage, find out how the man is thinking, how the woman is thinking, because that thinking pattern is what you are getting married to. If I stop now, I will bless somebody else. I say that mentality is what you are going to marry. Why I always enjoy talking about relationship is because I am swimming at the ocean of relationship of all connections. So I talk from my reading, don't talk from book. Hello? I say I talk from where? I talk from my pain. A few days ago, my wife confronted me. I said, "Daddy, you have changed. It is going difficult for me to fit into you. You have changed. And this change is hurting me." Are you hearing what I said?
Yes,
she's sitting down there. Then I say, "I'm sorry for all the hurt. But you see, this is the reality of my own church. He married me as a pastor. Now, but between the time she married me and now, I keep changing every day. And then I have come to the realm of change that every little thing makes meaning to me. And then I react." And then she said, "You don't used to react like this before." And then I said, "And before now, I used to be a very beautiful pastor, stay with people, relax with them, cry with them, pray with them, do everything with them, everything. Now, I preach, I teach, I do counseling. But those days, I didn't look at the future while I was using my energy as a youth. I didn't know that I was not saving my future. I was using my energy, sweat, tears, and blood, without considering the future. Until gradually I began to understand that a man needs to save his life by saving his work. Before I took this man, I asked them, 'Is there a camera in this place?' They said, 'Yes, if there's no camera, I will not speak.' Is that clear? I said, 'If it's not recorded, I will not do what?' Now, because the energy, what you took me to prepare what I'm sharing now, another 2 billion people need to share from what I'm preaching now. That is how to save my level. If you really make arrangement for it, I'll finish. I will not worry about you. Why? I may not be young and strong and agile to preach like this forever. So the one that I have leveled, I need to save it."
Sure.
Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Why Africans die and they are forgotten is because we spend so much of our energy and we don't save it.
You are right, sir.
Now, a few months or maybe years from now, what I'm sharing now will appear in the book. So that in another 2,000 years, in another generation of young people can share from it. Now that's how to save their life. Now, because of the way I am thinking now, every minute of my life, my brain is busy with the next thing I will share. Is that it? I am thinking of the next book that will come up. I'm thinking of what I will share tomorrow morning in family life. I am not looking at this congregation alone. I have contact with close to 500 people beyond the shores of Nigeria that I minister to online. So I'm also looking at them. And then I look at the children that will come after them. So my mind is set on those things. So my wife can be talking with me, and then an inspiration will be on the window. So now sometimes I'll be looking at her and my attention is on the situation. So she will notice that I am not paying attention to what she's saying. And then she will say, "Daddy, you are not paying attention." I said, "Madam, sorry, my dear." Now, sometimes that inspiration will be a heavy one that I cannot play with, because if you miss it, you may not come back. Now, when it comes like that, I will say, "Excuse me." She will say, "But we agree that we," I say, "Excuse me. Have my voice not changed? Is this still a general voice? Is this still a voice of a husband? Is she not wounded?" That is it.
Thank you,
my brother. As I'm explaining it to you now, that is how I explained to her one after the other, until she began to understand that the mentality of her husband has begun to change, and that this man needs to be given much time round about my mind. In understanding it, her peace returned, and then her joy increased. Can I, if I stop now, why not? Yeah, because talking about myself as a deaf, quoting by religious support. So, you know, many times young people say, "I love him, excuse me, stop that language, it will kill you." That language is one of the anointed poisons that people spread inside the body of Christ. Love. That thing you call love is poisonous. Now, I didn't say you should not love, but if you want to love, love the mentality of the person. If you didn't discover the mentality, don't love yet. Because what you are loving is not, you're not sure.
Thank you, sir.
Because you will pass through tests with the test of that love for longer. I said, "Don't do what?" Mentality is everything. Now, when we say relationship, we are talking about relationship as Christians, not just relationship. That means Christ-centered relationship. If you want to be a successful person in relationship, you should labor to receive the mentality of Christ. Now, you know you have your own person. Now, the you in you needs to be discovered. And that you in you needs to be submitted to Christ, so that the mentality of Christ can mingle and marry with your mentality to produce the new you that is attractive. A lot of people who are looking for a relationship has not produced the person that can attract the relationship. You that is raw, you that your mentality has not been affected by the word of God. You are not transformed on the inside. You are not qualified for a relationship. Except somebody who wants to eat poison for you. Why there is quarrel and fight and people break in relationship is because they assume that the person they are relating with is already a bread of life. So when they fall in love with the so-called bread of life, now when the real life in relationship begins, when they eat that bread, they eat poison, they start vomiting. Now sometimes they want to vomit when it is too late. You can't wait, it's late, you can't commit it. So, now, how do you understand some of this mentality? Time. There are key things in relationship. How the person uses time. What the person is talking. How he relates with money. But there are many, but I'm going to present on this thing. It is this. Now, the greatest gift you have is yourself. God does not intend that you will be made glorious from outside yourself. That is why when people want to be great outside themselves, they end up as slaves. Now, if if it is about yourself, then you need time. Somebody say time. You need time. Time to know yourself. Time to discover yourself. Now, you need to know how you can channel your energy. I'm talking to the youth. The Bible says the glory of the youth is what? Is their strength. So, your strength is the greatest gift you have now. So, it is the mentality you have that decides what happens to your energy. It's your mentality that decides what happens to your strength. Now, your strength is disseminated in three channels: your blood, your tears, and your sweat. So the question is, what is taking your sweat as a youth? What is taking your tears? What is taking your blood? Where are these three things going to? Where they are going to? Do they have hope for future? Or are you just spending it? You see, if you spend your energy, you will waste your future. If you invest it, you will save it. So, are you investing your energy or are you wasting it? All of us have 24 hours in a day. So, when 24 hours has finished, do you turn back and say, this is what I achieved today, this is the investment? Or do you just notice that 24 hours came and passed and nothing happened, and your day is going? So when you want to relate with somebody, you should pay attention to how the person is using his or her time. What does he do with his or her time? Where does he pour his tears? Where does he pour his sweat? Where does he pour his blood? These three things will help you to know whether those places that he's paying attention to, can you manage the places? I said in my book, where they're listening, if you want to marry a man, marry his work first. Because the work controls the man. If you can't marry the work, don't worry. Because if you marry the man outside his work will start you in different marriage. Now, I said talk. How you know somebody that you will stay with is the willingness of the person to stay with you. And one of the things that control that willingness is what you are talking, what you are discussing. When you stay with somebody, you believe you should fall in love. One of the signs is that you will not be tired of talking with yourselves. There will always be something to keep talking about. That will be sweet memory. It will connect to the future. It will explain the past. It will inspire the presence. It will be there. If it's not there, start withdrawing. Because you can't force it. Hallelujah. So now, the Bible says, out of the abundance of the heart, the man speaks. So the person you are talking with, what he's saying tells you the meditations of his heart. And the meditations of the heart control what the man is saying. So, what does the person always bring to the table for discussion? If you know it, it's key to understanding his mentality. It's not far from it. Now, you see, emotions come from impatience. In relationship, one of the things to look out for is how to understand the person's emotion and manage it. Why we slap in relationship? Is that we lost control of our emotion, we couldn't manage it. While we're quiet, send this message that if the other person finishes reading it, there will be royal riot in his brain. Some people will start misbehaving. It's because we couldn't manage our emotion. Now, don't fall in love until you understand the emotional makeup of the person. Because that emotion is what you're going to marry. Yes, sir. Pay attention. You see, emotion is either way. Some people, when they are happy, they are dangerous. They cause more problems when they are happy. Then there are some people that, when they are angry, all of us know how anger can manifest. Now, there are some people that, you know, in their nature, we want them to practice silence. Now, in their nature, they can be very happy in a short while, and can also be very angry in a short while. Then, if you want to fall in love with that person, you should understand that emotion and receive grace to manage it.
Yes, sir.
Why Jesus was a master of masters, in that he has 12 apostles and he was able to understand the emotion of all of them from A to Z. He knew that Judas had enough anointing to sell him and collect money and still be following him up and down. And he managed him with that emotion. He said, who do you mean? Say, I am. Peter said, Christ the Son of the Living God. He said, this is by the Spirit, it's not a flesh and blood. In the another less than 1 hour, he was saying, the Son of Man is going to die. He's going to resurrect. Peter said, hey, stop! How can you say you will die? He said, you are Son of God. He said, get behind me, Satan. How do you call somebody Satan after you say that Holy Ghost is using you less than 1 hour? That is fucking time. If that kind of person is your wife, God help you. If it's your husband, you need grace. And yet, there are other things inside the person that will attract to you to say, hey, it's not this person, I will not mind. So, it's okay. So at the end of the day, it boils down to we understanding the mentality of ourselves and the other person. Now, let me rush because of time. Under emotion, let me bring the drama for you. Esther, the queen, you know her in the Bible, was in between two opinions. That is, Mordecai's influence on her couldn't leave her even in the palace. Right in the palace, he was still answering to Mordecai's request and demand. Righteously. And then his money again, that is over 170 provinces. So that lady, is she not sitting on the altar of fire? Mordecai said, there is a decree that all the Jews will die. So do something to change it, or else between you, you will die. And the king said, nobody comes to tell me anything until after 30 days. So if you're in the shoe of Esther, what do you do? Now Esther was able to know that the emotions of Mordecai carry her personal life. And then the emotions of the king carry her marriage, and she lived it with. You will tell you how she was able to manage the two and came out successful. That success you see in her is in the ability of the lady to know herself. I will end with this. Self-discovery. I had a handsome young man talking about it before I came up. It's beautiful. You need to know who you are. You need to know your mentality. And then you need to now say, who can get married to this mentality? Who can this mentality marry? Finally, I talk about money. You need to know the person's mentality around about money. In life, in a relationship setting, some people are cheaters, some people are sowers. The Bible talk about he that gives it to the sower and bread to the eater. Some people are what? Eaters, some people are sowers. So you need to find out who you are relating with, or who you want to relate with, or who you want to fall in love with. Is this person, does he have a mentality of eater or mentality of sower? In business language, you call it investor's mentality and then spender's mentality. If you give 1 naira to someone who is a sower, he will think about the next investment. When you put the same money in the hand of an eater, he will think about the next thing to buy. You will say, this clothes are raining and I'm not going to need to buy it now. Now, understanding this financial emotion is a key to success. Or have you not noticed that second on the list of the things that cause problems in the world is money? Which one is number one? Now, which one is number one? Sex is number one, two is money. Is it only one person that is not there? Are we not reading? Are we not getting ready for marriage? Let the lady ready. Don't allow me to take you by surprise. Hallelujah. Now Jesus will say, don't live for yourself treasures on earth. We are more to eat. He said, leave your treasures where? In heaven. The heaven there is not this invisible place. The heaven there is talking about spiritual investment that will bring you spiritual return that will last forever. It's talking about change. The glory of the Jews is in their ability to convert everything they own into their blessing. Like the man said, he discovered the gold in the land. And in order to save the gold, he began to ask God, please transfer this gold into my blessing. So he went through conversion until every piece of that gold on the land transformed and became a person inside him. So every part of his life became a golden life. So if you speak, the speak has gold. His hand is golden hand. So anywhere he appears, gold appears. Now that is the kind of thing that God is talking about. Transfer every treasure you have into a golden treasure in your person. Make yourself valuable. It is that value in you that people want to relate with. It is the value that you should value. Not the pointed nose. Not the figure eight. Because this figure eight will change shape when you enter the balloon and come out. Oh my God. Hallelujah. Praise God. So, the emotions of money is important. And money is important in relationship. Find it. Understand yourself first. Who are you? Do you belong to Eden's or do you belong to? So, finally, what must I do now? For this master to keep the work for me. Number one, if possible, don't start a relationship until you are not better. For God's sake, what should a child in JS, SS1, undergraduate, first year, what are you looking for inside a relationship? You just want to wound your future. It is just because you think that everybody, I must have a boyfriend. Excuse me, it is not a must. You don't really need it. That is the corruption of a generation. From all the energy, all the time, all the emotion, everything you should divert into reading and getting converted to a valuable person. You start sharing it with your food that doesn't have any plan for your future.
Yes, thank you, sir.
If he doesn't think they want to say, he said there is time for. Now, number two, know yourself first. Paul said that I know him. That I mean the power of his resurrection, the fellowship of his suffering, that I may be conformable unto his death, with the expectation that I will attain to the resurrection of the dead. Now that is talking about your inner change. That's talking about making yourself valuable. A Christian relationship is a relationship based on the value that Christ has put inside you. The Bible says Christ in you is the hope of glory. So it is about, I'm already in number three, it's about becoming the Christ that is in you. My little children of whom I travel again in pain, only Christ is formed in you. Galatians 4:19. He said, Christ in you is the hope of glory. How much of this Christ is in you? Now, people say that we're praying for marriage. You don't need to pray for marriage. It's a waste of investment. What you need to do is to pray for your change. Take your change. When you transform and unveil the value of Christ in you, it will attract whatever you want. People mind value. Not prayer. As everybody wants. Value. Why should Ruth get married for years? Lose her husband for more than 10 years. So after like 15 or 20 years of first encounter in marriage, the woman came back and still got married before some young ladies who are not up to wait. Shame on them. There's something in that lady that a child of God must prayerfully find out from God to affect your future. She brought out the value of a woman in her, and the men didn't consider whether she had married before or not. They left their wife, left the younger generation, and went after a widow. So if you tell me that you are stranded, I know that there is a value in you that you don't want to invest in. Finally, he said, let vision attract your mate in relationship. Bible says, where there is no vision, the people perish. And then he said, he that keepeth the law, happy is he. Which law? The law of the vision. It is who you are that determines who you relate with. And then when you know who you are will give you the law of your life. Now, anybody who wants to marry you should understand the law of your life and get married to that law. So the law of my life as a minister is that I should minister with everything I have and then save the labor. My work should put on immortality and my person should put on immortality. So putting on immortality in my person, in my work, in my name is what is guiding my life. Then the law of immortality is guiding me roundabout. If you want to be successful around me, a wife, a servant, or anything, you fit into that law. That's the relationship. Father, for everyone that I've had, and for as many as we hear, let the grace of relationship rooted in the unfolding of the grace of Christ, Lord, let it close every one of us. Let it be our inheritance. Let it be our blessing. Let it be our covering. Let it be our guide. Let the Spirit in Christ moderate us and then give us the